Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome to one and all, graduates and guests, families and friends. Today is a day of celebration, a rite of passage. My name is Peter Duick, and I am the Director of Admissions and Registrar here at Royal Roads University. Those of us who work in my office are lucky. We were there at the beginning of your journey at Royal Roads, listening as many of you expressed doubts about your readiness to embark on this academic path, and watching as you gathered the determination to make it happen. Then we were there again, paying careful attention as you completed every step along the way, recording your every success. And now, it's our pleasure to join you as you celebrate this accomplishment. What you have achieved is nothing short of amazing. Many of you have been balancing the demands of your educational experience alongside family responsibilities and career obligations, and that's never easy. The time has come to sit back, take a deep breath, and enjoy every moment as we celebrate you and the work you've now finished. Today marks the 40th convocation for Royal Roads University. We are so pleased that you've been able to join us. Today is your celebration. Together we look back with pride at what you've accomplished in this phase of your academic studies. And just as importantly, we look ahead with hope, knowing you have plans to use your newly enriched potential to create positive change in the world around us. Before we begin, I have a few points to share with you. First, on your way into the theater, you should have received a convocation program. This includes the order of this afternoon's ceremony and the names of this fall's graduates. Second, in just a few moments, you will hear the strains of bagpipes announcing the academic procession of the platform party. I will ask you to rise just before the piper enters the theater. Meanwhile, please ensure that all cell phones and other electronic devices are turned off for the duration of the ceremony. Also, we ask that you remain at your seats for the duration of the proceedings. Professional photographers are positioned to capture the moment your graduate crosses the stage. Please do not block the aisles, as of course our graduates will use these to access the stage. Thank you very much. I hear the bagpipes, ladies and gentlemen. Please rise and remain at your seats for the academic reception. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please join in the singing of our Canadian national anthem, led by Ms. Andrea Pollock. Thank you, Andrea. You may be seated. I am now pleased to invite Asmanahai Antoine, Nuchalnath Tulkwat Nation, and our Indigenous Education and Student Services Manager to provide us with a welcome to the ancestral lands to begin our ceremony.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you. Chancellor, President, Vice Chancellor, honored guests, Board of Governors, faculty, staff, family, friends, and especially the graduate students, congratulations. Let's begin our afternoon by acknowledging the traditional lands of where this ceremony is taking place. Let's acknowledge Kosopson, Esquimalt Nation, and their hereditary chief, Andy Thomas. Let's also acknowledge Lekwungen Songhees Nation and their elected chief, Ron Sam, who both have given me permission to be able to welcome and begin the ceremony today. I want to say on behalf of both chiefs, they send their regrets and they could not be here this afternoon, but they do send their congratulations and wish all the graduate students all the best. Many folks think this is wanting to know why. Why do we start our ceremonies in such a manner? And I just want to raise my hands up to the Railroads University community for allowing us to conduct this important business as a sign of respect, of reconciliation between Indigenous and non-Indigenous families, but also acknowledging the history within our country. Haichka Siam Kleko Kleko. My name Asmanahai means caring for precious ones. It comes from my mother's family, my late mother's family, Vera Thompson, from Tulkwat Nation of Nuchalna lands. My last name, Antoine, comes from my late father's family, from Saika's Nation, from Carrier Sakani lands. I've been residing in the Lekwungen lands now for about 20 years. I am so honored to call this place my home away from home. I want to introduce myself because that brings a personal connection. You now know who I am, and when I meet you, I want to know who you are. And I've done that with many of our students, and some of them who are sitting in the audience today. And I am so humbled and happy to be standing here to do this. I want to acknowledge the oldest member in the audience today, and just raise my hands up to you, because you've led a pathway, whether you've known it or not, or have known it, and I just want to raise my hands for laying a pathway for your family members, but also for your community members to see that. And I also want to raise my hands up to the youngest member in this audience to just say, you are the reason why we do the work we do, and it's for the next seven generations, so we can live in harmony and peace and be kind to one another. Graduates, continue to be beautiful, strong, for today, for tomorrow, and for life. Haichika siam, kleko, kleko.
We are grateful to Asmana High for joining us today and for reminding us of the rich heritage of human presence on these beautiful lands. Haichika. Thank you. It's now my pleasure to introduce our academic platform party, and I'll ask each to rise briefly as I call out their names. Ladies and gentlemen, the Chancellor of Royal Roads University and Chair of the University's Board of Governors, Mr. Wayne Strandland. The President and Vice Chancellor, Dr. Alan Cahoon. Our honorary degree recipient today, Dr. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond. The Vice President, Academic and Provost, Dr. Steve Grundy. The Vice President, Communications and Advancement, Ms. Catherine Harold. The Vice President, Global Marketing and Business Development, Dr. Pedro Marquez. The Vice President and Chief Financial Officer, Mr. Dan Tulip. The Associate Vice President, Research and Faculty Affairs, Dr. Mary Bernard. The Associate Vice President, Student and Academic Services, Ms. Roberta Mason. The Dean of the Faculty of Management, Dr. William Holmes. And you've already met our Indigenous Education and Student Services Manager, Ms. Asmanahai Antoine. We also have with us today members of our Board of Governors, Ms. Elizabeth Bicknell, Ms. Candace Perkins, and Mr. Bernard Slaney. Now, we also have with us in the platform party members of the faculty and support staff of Royal Roads University, and I now ask them to rise, all of them, and be recognized.
With your permission, I'm going to remove this hilarious hat. After this morning's session, I looked in the mirror in my room, robing room, and there's a big ring around my forehead, and I thought, that's why I'm dizzy. It doesn't get better, does it? But honestly, I thought I was going to pass out. It was just so tight after this morning. Right, Clint Eastwood, eat your heart out. Distinguished guests, President Allen, governors, deans, directors, faculty, staff, and Royal Roads graduates. Haichka, good afternoon. To our brothers and sisters of the Esquimalt and Songhees nations, thank you for graciously sharing your traditional land, for joining us in this celebration, and for adding such memorable ceremony to the festivities. On behalf of Royal Roads, thank you, my great sister Asmanai. Once again, I am privileged to preside over a Royal Roads convocation, the 40th convocation of Royal Roads University. On behalf of the Board of Governors, I welcome family, loved ones, and friends who have joined us to celebrate this special day. Thank you for joining us and honoring our graduates. At this morning's session of the convocation, we conferred an honorary Doctor of Laws degree on Canadian poet, author, and orator, Dr. David White. And we recognized Canadian hero, statesman, and philanthropist, Dr. Eric Charman, with the Chancellor's Community Recognition Award. This afternoon, we look forward to hearing from distinguished and well-known children's rights advocate, Dr. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond, upon whom Royal Roads is privileged to confer an honorary Doctor of Laws degree. Mary Ellen, we are grateful to you for accepting this honorary Doctor of Laws degree from Royal Roads. I hope it is as special to you as it is to us. Thank you. What a great person. Honorable graduates, thank you for choosing Royal Roads. Thank you for dignifying its people, tradition, and heritage with your kindness, generosity, humor, and outstanding accomplishments. You are part of a proud tradition. You are lifelong members of a family of leaders, members of a proud culture. Like us on stage, you have made a wise decision to join the Royal Roads family. As your Chancellor, I take personal responsibility for ensuring you have made the wise choice. As a Royal Roads leader, I must deliver on that promise. I am proud to be satisfied that you are clear evidence that I have done that. Above all, we are leaders. We embrace opportunities to make tough decisions. We seek these opportunities, welcome them, and make decisions with principle and compassion. We laugh out loud as often as we can. We forgive ourselves. We put all unnecessary baggage on the burn pile, as I call it. And we pack our lives with questions, challenges, and adventures. In time of sorrow and pain, I want you to remember yourself that there is no difference between exquisite sorrow and exquisite joy. The chest feels as tight and the tears just as salty, because there is no difference. And when great sorrow befalls you, as it will, I want you to know in your heart that you are worth it, because you are worth it. During my adult life, my greatest dread has been not the threat or prospect of pain and sorrow, or the existence of pain and sorrow. It has been that I may not be worth my pain and sorrow and sufferings and joy. My prayer for you today is that you will be worth yours. There's a glass bowl in the gowning area in the front foyer. In it, you will find tokens of my appreciation for your choosing Royal Roads. These are my handy dandy Admit One tickets. Help yourself. They look like this. The ticket is something I've created with my family over a lifetime, and which I carry with me at all times. This good old Admit One ticket has saved me more times than I can count. It's a small thing, but I want you to have it. It is a personal gift from me to you. I'm going to talk about the ticket just for a bit. I know that the people on stage have heard this before, and they may be saying, well, there's the old bugger preaching again. But I'm going to preach again anyway, because I need it. I need to remind myself of my weakness. I need to be able to pull out something and, you know, remember that I did it. I created this, and my family created this, and I have to live up to it. At any rate, I've tried to reduce basically a lifetime of wishes to one ticket, and there are four columns of seven each. And in the first column, I like to recite the virtues. You know them, I know them, but I have to remind myself. Courage, justice, prudence, temperance. Those are the four cardinal ones. And then the heavenly virtues, which we all know, of faith, hope, and charity. Then I remind myself of the vices, and I've got them all, and how to deal with them. Anger, which I try to deal with by exercising patience. Greed, by exercising generosity. Gluttony, by exercising moderation. Jealousy, by exercising confidence. Laziness, by exercising diligence. Lust, by exercising dignity or elegance. And pride, of course, by exercising humility. And then I recite the works of the corporal works of mercy, and you know them. Feed the hungry, give drink to the thirsty, clothe the naked, shelter strangers, solace the sick, minister to prisoners, and bury the dead. I didn't make those up. Those are in Scripture. And lastly, the last seven on this modest ticket are reminders of the perils to humanity. I know them, and they're as honest today as they've been all my life. The perils to humanity are commerce without morality, knowledge without character, pleasure without conscience, politics without principle, science without humanity, wealth without work, and one of my favorites, worship without sacrifice. I've got them all, and I've got them on this little piece of paper that I can pull out of my wallet when I'm in trouble or when I need help. I've plasticized these things with my handy dandy little laminating machine. $17. $17. And I believe that was at, not Home Depot, but Canadian Tire. And you want to know something? My beloved spouse, Greek spouse, Elena, who insists on reading anything that I script, reminded me that I can get a better laminating machine for $14 at Staples. And I said, what do you mean better? She said, well, it's not only cheaper, but it handles larger structures. It handles a wider variety. It roasts them faster, and you know. And I thought, what the hell are you talking about? You know, for $3, but that's Elena, for $3. And I said, you know, I thought you were going to tell me that it would, you know, what they call it, not plasticized, but maybe vulcanized and your worst neighbor or something like that. But no, she figured, I got to get something cheaper. But I've put this in plastic because sometimes I pull it out when I'm drinking wine and I spill wine on this ticket, and this one I can wash off. And it stays with me all the time. And I got to tell you that the flesh is weak, or mine is weak, and I need to remind myself frequently about the things that I believe and I've believed all my life. But enough. Society needs our leadership, our statesmanship, our elegance, and dignity. Let's practice these virtues and continue to refine these indispensable royal roads traits and values. We will do this consciously and unabashedly, demonstrating to our brothers and sisters across all nations and cultures the great leaders we are and that we practice what we preach. My dear friends, honorable Royal Roads graduates, you'll never know how proud I am of you and how proud I am to be here and be part of the leadership. Remember to live your learning, your values-based learning. Remember each other and keep in touch. Thank you for your patience. God bless.
Thank you, Chancellor Strandlin and members of the Board of Governors. That we're going to recognize Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond, colleagues, faculty, staff, students, alumni, and friends. Thanks for being part of today's celebration. Thanks for being here and being able to recognize the contributions of friends and family. What has value is something that we pay attention to. And clearly, by your participation today, you're paying attention to an accomplishment, a success, and we want to be able to celebrate that with you. And thank you for, Asma, for reminding us that we are on the traditional territories of the Kosamsan and Lekwungen people. And it's a privilege to be in this community. You know, Royal Roads was a place, a gathering place for local First Nations as they traded, as they discovered, as they learned, as they held celebrations, and as they socialized. And we try to bring that tradition together. We celebrate and acknowledge the importance of place, our roots and traditions, and our pride in being British Columbia's most innovative, responsive, and progressive public university, and I say that with pride. Graduates, you're part of this extraordinary learning legacy that's been our past. This special place has sustained and inspired so many people just like you to build dreams, live fully, and realize their potential. 21 years ago, the founders of Royal Roads University were inspired to create something new on the educational landscape. They wanted to create an entirely different learning and research environment where innovation and learning could flourish. And they invited people just like you to build it with them. Innovation is something we hear a lot about. It's something, as a nation, we are challenged to cultivate and demonstrate. What exactly does it mean to innovate, and what does it mean for Royal Roads? When the university was established in 1995, it meant stretching the boundaries of the academy and long-standing academic and educational traditions to create new pathways to academic and personal achievement. Royal Roads pioneered the blended learning model in the post-secondary sector in Canada and extended fledgling technologies to connect students to this special place, from every place. The university then took a bold step to connect people who wanted to bring together multiple viewpoints to change their organizations, to change their sectors and their communities. We introduced an institution-wide focus on interdisciplinary discovery, knowing that the critical challenges of the day could not be understood and addressed by relying on rigid, traditional discipline-focused study. So we designed a university without discipline-based departments and degrees. Instead, we created schools and programs which are, in essence, interdisciplinary. We did this intentionally. We created a learning environment which enables students and faculty to respond to the complex and pressing issues like climate change, natural and human-made disasters, values-based leadership, ethical business and governance, and human rights. We did this with the objective of preparing you, our graduates, with the skills and competencies to change lives, improve professional and personal practice, and to make a difference in our local and global communities. As Royal Roads University students, you experienced our interdisciplinary approach when you dissolved boundaries to solve complex problems, or when you examined an issue from multiple points of view. And you experienced our interdisciplinary approach when you were invited to integrate knowledge from your professional and personal experience into your studies. The way our schools and faculty integrate multiple academic disciplines in our program's offerings, and the way Royal Road students integrate learning from work, school, and life makes us exceptionally proud. As Royal Roads University graduates, you have an ability to approach a challenge from more than one perspective. This adds value to you personally, and in your work, and in your workplace. Innovation at Royal Roads also means hands-on, integrated, action-oriented research with ethical collaboration between researchers, community, business, and government, which leads to real results. We see this kind of work from our students and graduates from every school and every program. For example, while racing as a member of the Canadian National Alpine Ski Team in Sochi, Bachelor of Commerce graduate Brad Spence launched a foundation to support children battling life-threatening diseases while also generating awareness for helmet safety, one of which was worn by Olympic luger Sam Edney, who is in the graduating class today. And Doctor of Social Science graduate Carla Funk's research and how overseas development work is changing at the hands of private funders that will lead to real change are things that we celebrate. As Royal Roads University students, you experience the opportunity to roll up your sleeves and get involved in relevant research that makes a difference in your communities, in your businesses, in your organizations, and in government. As Royal Roads University graduates, you have an ability to face real-world challenges and practical solutions for your communities and organizations. Innovation at Royal Roads University also means creating communities for life. Cohort-based learning is central to our learning and teaching model. It takes many forms at Royal Roads, from engagement in formalized, authentic activities like case competitions, leadership challenges, action research, inquiry labs, to less formal activities like Moodle discussions and collaborative papers, and late-night talks during residency. I'm sure some of you remember these. As Royal Roads University students, you and your cohort members have shared experiences and relationships that can continue to enhance your lives and your careers. You have experienced the value of collaborative learning and the importance of sharing your experience and perspectives with your colleagues. So innovation at Royal Roads is more than our interdisciplinary approach, our real-world focus, or our cohort-based learning. Royal Roads is a living laboratory where our focus on innovation is manifested in our students and our graduates. the innovators themselves. The real proof of innovation at Royal Roads is you and what you do. I invite you to continue the learning process, to stay engaged with Royal Roads as alumni, and participate in activities and initiatives. You now have a stake in the future of your institution. We invite you to keep connected. We are proud to confer credentials on 800 graduates in the Faculty of Management and Faculty of Social and Applied Sciences at today's 40th convocation ceremony, bringing the number of Royal Roads alumni to more than 24,000. Graduates from around the world have earned degrees, certificates, and diplomas at this convocation ceremonies. 19 countries are represented by new alumni here today, including Barbados, Bolivia, Canada, China, Hong Kong, India, Japan, Republic of Korea, New Zealand, Nigeria, Poland and the Russian Federation, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Saudi Arabia, South Africa, Taiwan, United Republic of Tanzania, Trinidad and Tobago, and Vietnam. I would especially like to recognize those graduates who have traveled many miles and crossed continents to take part in today's ceremony. We recognize and appreciate your commitment to Royal Roads, and we are very proud to welcome you, all of you, to our community. This morning, we're also proud to present the Governor General's Gold Medal to Brooke Hoja for the most outstanding thesis or graduate program this year. He graduated with a Master's of Arts in Disaster Management. He took a creative approach to his research and created an accessible game that combines disaster resilient theory and social innovation values. Congratulations, Brooks. We also presented with pride the Governor General's Silver Medal to Heather Amos for the highest academic standard in a bachelor's degree program this year. And this afternoon, I'm pleased to see the first graduating class of the Master's of Business Administration in Executive Management International Business to receive their credentials. Congratulations on your achievement and your trailblazing role for this new and important specialization in our MBA program. It is my honor to congratulate you on your achievement, your hard work, and your success now and into the future. Can I remind you just of one thing? Having an education is not impressive. Using it is. Hajka, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we turn now to greetings from the Government of British Columbia. The Honorable Andrew Wilkinson, Minister of Advanced Education, sends his regrets and asked me to pass along the following message. Dear students, staff and faculty, friends and family, and honored guests, welcome to Fall Convocation, a time to celebrate and reflect on the hard work and dedication that students gathered here have demonstrated to earn their spot among more than 24,000 Royal Roads University alumni. Graduates from the Faculty of Social and Applied Sciences and the Faculty of Management are being recognized today as Royal Roads celebrates its 40th convocation. Throughout the course of its history, Royal Roads has remained steadfast in its commitment to providing students with the opportunity to engage in lifelong learning. Royal Roads is recognized for its innovative programs that enables students in all stages of their lives and careers to engage in higher education. Investing in your education at an institution like Royal Roads will provide you with rewards that will last a lifetime and will create a foundation for your personal and professional success. Today, Royal Roads University is recognizing three extraordinary individuals for their outstanding accomplishments: David White and Dr. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond are receiving the Honorary Doctor of Laws, and Eric Charman is receiving the Chancellor's Community Recognition Award. Congratulations on all of these achievements, and thank you for your leadership and dedication and for enriching the world around you. Congratulations, graduates, and thank you to the families, faculty and staff of Royal Roads University, for providing support, guidance, and inspiration throughout this journey. On behalf of the Government of British Columbia, I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Sincerely, the Honorable Andrew Wilkinson. Thank you.
We are pleased to confer the honorary Doctor of Laws degree today. Dr. Robin Cox, will you present the honorary degree recipient, Dr. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond?
As a woman and a feminist, and as someone who is passionate about supporting the rights and resilience of children and youth, it is truly my delight to introduce Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond, a lawyer, a judge, a children's rights advocate, and a rule breaker. Last night at a dinner celebration, this morning's recipient of an honorary doctorate, renowned poet David White, spoke of heartbreak as the entry point of every vocation. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond's vocation for the past 10 years, as British Columbia's very first representative for children and youth, is testimony to the truth of that sentiment. Through her courage and tenacity, her willingness to take risks and break rules, in order to act against injustice, and through her wisdom and passion, she has demonstrated the power of a broken, open heart. Since 2006, she has shone a light on the needs of the small, the silenced, and the forgotten, and has worked to support children and youth in government care, such as those in foster homes, group homes, or in youth custody. Dr. Turpel-Lafond has especially shown leadership as a champion of rights for Indigenous children and youth, and she has fought persistently for government to address the effects of colonialism on Indigenous communities. During her time as representative, she has helped more than 17,000 families receive better services in BC. She has helped lower the number of children and youth in care by more than 2,000 compared to 10 years ago, and has encouraged adoptions of children in long-term foster care. In a particular example of her esteem for education, she has helped BC double its school completion rates for children and youth in government care. Also, she was also a driving force behind a program in which 12 post-secondary institutions, Royal Roads proudly among them, offer tuition waivers or reductions for former youth in care. Her commitment to education shows in her own academic credentials. Dr. Turpel-Lafond holds a PhD from Harvard Law School, a Master of Law in International Law from Cambridge University, and a law degree from York University's Osgoode Hall. In 1998, she was the first person of Indigenous descent appointed to the Provincial Court of Saskatchewan. During her time on the bench, she worked to increase access to justice and judicial independence. As a criminal law judge, she worked to better serve the needs of young people in the justice system. It is our true privilege to add to Dr. Turpel-Lafond's many accolades and awards, which include numerous honorary degrees, as well as holding the distinction of Indigenous People's Counsel from the Indigenous Bar Association and being a mentor with the Pierre Elliott Trudeau Foundation. For her service to Canada and British Columbia, and especially her service to children and youth, it is my deep, deep honor to present Dr. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond for the degree Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
Dr. Mary Ellen Turpel-Lafond, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Royal Roads University Act, and in accordance with the recommendation of the Board of Governors of Royal Roads University, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Laws honoris causa, with all the rights, privileges, and honors here and elsewhere thereto appertaining. Dr. Turpel-Lafond will now be hooded by Dr. Steve Grundy, Vice President of Academic and Provost. Dr. Ellen Cahoon will now present Dr. Turpel-Lafond with her degree. It is with great pleasure that I now call on Dr. Turpel-Lafond to deliver the convocation address, and I need a hug.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you very much to the Chancellor, to the President, to the Board of Governors, to the faculty. Also, congratulations to my fellow graduates. I'm very excited to watch each of you cross the stage and to share this day with you. It's terrific. Thank you very much to Robin for that lovely introduction. And it's a great honor to receive this doctorate. Although I do have a few other degrees, my kids say I have more degrees than a thermometer. But this one is very important to me, first of all, because Royal Roads is a unique place. It's a unique educational institution that takes people who have sometimes already achieved something in their careers and makes them vulnerable to see things differently, to learn, and to be open-minded in a new way, sometimes at different stages of their career. And that's a very important thing, because one of the values that I certainly have learned in my education and my career is to be open to difference and to be open to another way of thinking. And education is fundamentally about being vulnerable to that, being vulnerable to something that might be very different and actually can be quite frightening, because you take a chance at education. One of the chances you take is that you could fail, that you may not make it up across this platform, or that if you fail, you have to accept that failure and try again and maybe fail better. And so education is about that testing of yourself. And every person that gets an education has someone in their family, in their school, someone that has motivated them to be open to difference. That might be someone who wishes for them to be themselves, like a parent who, instead of wishing for their child to be just like them, says, I'm going to honor this child that I have and want them to be exactly who they're going to be, even if they're going to be completely different than me and it's going to make me crazy, I'm still going to honor that. Being open to difference, being vulnerable to change, these are things that have been so important to me in my time as representative for children and youth. It's been very good for me to work with and support children, youth, and their families, and not coming to that situation with my mind made up, but coming to that situation with an open mind, being vulnerable to connecting, vulnerable to learning, and vulnerable to listening. Because 9 times out of 10, the problem that I thought I was solving ended up being a very different problem when I sat down and listened to children, youth, and their families. And very, very often it was about how those children, youth, and their families needed to be accepted because they're different. They needed not to be stigmatized because they had a child or youth in the family who was experiencing a significant mental health crisis and had been stigmatized. They needed to be supported, a mom that needed to be supported because her child had autism and didn't want to feel like she was to blame for that. Or a school that needed to be supported because they were trying to do something different and supportive to kids. And I really want to make a shout out to schools in British Columbia and the patience of our teachers who waited patiently for 14 long years for the Supreme Court of Canada to finally tell them last week that they were right to stand up for kids, for smaller classes and more supports for kids with special needs. It was a long journey for those teachers for 14 years, and I hope those kids that maybe didn't get those supports over the years and all of those teachers that put their heart and soul into the education of children that were often very different and sometimes very challenging in the classroom, I hope that they will have a chance in their career to see change because they stood up and fought all the way to the Supreme Court of Canada. And that's an important point about education and change. If you are open to change and you're an agent of change, you need to be patient. The Chancellor grew up in a part of Saskatchewan around Round Lake and Crooked Lake, and I think he probably had a few pickerel from the same lake I've had a few pickerel from over the years, but there's a saying from Saskatchewan that I love, kind of from that area. It's called a lean dog runs a long race. And that is when you're an advocate for change of any kind, when you're changing an organization, when you're even changing your own family dynamic to accept someone who might have been a black sheep 10 years ago because they're gay or they're transgendered or they didn't maybe do what the parent or a sibling thought they should do, the lean dog has to run that long race, which is you have to remain resolute that the values that you can stand up for, much like the values that the Chancellor has identified in his ticket, and I'm glad that's laminated because I'm gonna get that ticket and use it. Those values sometimes take a long time to be proven true. And so even in my job as representative, half of the time when I look back, I think I should have done so much more because there's so much more work to be done. The other half of the time I say I'm glad I did what I did because I learned a great deal. But the most important thing is your values deepen and you don't change. And people with education know one thing. You can be patient, and if you work together and keep an open mind, you can do good things for each other. You can make the world a better place. You can support people during very difficult times. But most important, you yourself can have a better life. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Turpel-Lafond. Royal Roads University is proud to sit on a National Historic Site that offers such a diverse and unique setting for our students to study in. Today, we would like to share with you a few visual souvenirs that you shared with us to help you reflect on what you experienced here.
Could I now ask the graduates to please rise for presentation to the Chancellor? Mr. Chancellor, I present to you this graduating class of Royal Roads University, on whom you have conferred the degrees, certificates, and diplomas to which they are entitled.
Thank you, Dr. Grundy. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors and on the recommendation of the Academic Council of the University, I have admitted each of you to the credential for which you are entitled. I have invested you with all the due rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. May you always be mindful of the motto of this university, living our learning. Thank you.
Please be seated. Mr. Chancellor and members of the Boards of Governors, we will now present the graduates from their respective programs. We would also like to acknowledge those graduates watching from afar. I would like to introduce Dr. William Holmes, Dean of the Faculty of Management.
Good afternoon. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Master of Arts in Tourism Management program. Fiona Margaret Anderson, Tourism Management MA, Ted Wilson Memorial Award for Lifelong Learning. Natalie Louisa Thiessen, Laura and Mike DeJong Award. Han Wang. Our Master of Business Administration program has been offered throughout Asia since 1999 through our educational partners. We would like to thank graduates who were able to attend today's ceremony. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Master of Business Administration Executive Management program. Georgina Ann Altman. Scott Stephen Barrard. Melanie Ray Burton. John David Ellis. Cheryl Dawn Fix. Adam Larry Fraser. Patrick Joseph Gouch. Terrace Andrew Kinzerski. Douglas Donald Kraus. Holly Lynn Lenk. Bjorn Herman Meyer. Shalana Marie Postings. Robin Kaur Tour. Braden Ross Daniel Oldbury Waters. Jihao Tsai. YK Chung. Yuk Ching Ho. Y Sum Pamela Hui. Thank you. Po Yan Lau. Charlie Lee. Y Kit Yip. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Master of Business Administration Executive Management International Business Program. Giuseppe Angelo Damiani. James Christopher Furlong. Joanne Waluski. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Master of Business Administration Executive Management Leadership Program. Jeffrey David Debian. Kelly Robert Longley. Holly Dawn Pateman. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Master of Business Administration Executive Management Management Consulting Program. Joan Deborah Baer. Todd Anthony Den Engelson. Jordan William Fraser. Jacqueline Nicole Gallagher. Thanks. Kevin Richard Gatley. Yvette Maria Giguno. Lisa Marie Pinechel. Janice Elaine Marcoux. Heidi Marie Sherwood. Eric C. Douglas, Entrepreneur and Virtual Graduate Residence Scholarship. Angela Nicole Treglia. Gordon Cameron Whale. Janelle Nicole Whitley. Wayne Douglas, young husband. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Bachelor of Arts in Global Tourism Management program. Peishuan Li. Chelsea Marie Emily Smith. Founders Award. Abby Jean Willett. President's Scholar Award. Majid Nureddin Yusuf. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Bachelor of Arts in International Hotel Management program. Faisal Ahmed Al-Rubaya. Yushuang Mar. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Bachelor of Commerce in Entrepreneurial Management program. Andrew Ross Arnold. Raya Michelle Bertram. Michael James Bateman. Brianne Kara Butcher. Christopher Carl Boff, Founders Award. David Reynolds Buchanan, Grant Thornton LLP Award. Kanako Calder. Drew Cameron. Kelsey Elizabeth Carragher. Claire Ann Chappelle. Kira Amber Clark, Grant Thornton LLP Award. Heather Lynn Crockett. Brian Paul Dominic. Anna Jacqueline Daugherty. Natalie Germaine Fufat. Courtney Jason Gallant. Roseanne Paige Gibson. David William Christopher Harris. Owen William Helfrich. Perpetual Chrysanthi Jayapal. Amy Lynn. Ilios Mamadaliov. Kelsey Maud Mooney. Matthew Bruce Nicholson. Falakami Olusola Ojetola. Noelle Mary Mosdale Quinn. Catherine Marie Ryan, President's Scholar Award. Shay Shinaba. Timothy Andrew Televi, President's Scholar Award. Melissa Emmeline Townsend. Karan Amar Wadwani, Commerce Alumni Scholarship Founders Award. David Bartlett Zinneman. I am now honored to present to you today graduates from our Graduate Certificate in Executive Coaching Program. Lillian Ann Underwood. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Graduate Certificate in Strategic Human Resources Management Program. Shayla Dawn Huber. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Graduate Certificate in Workplace Immigration Program. Carla Deanne Crozier. I would now like to present graduates from the School of Communication and Culture. I'm honored to present to you today graduates from our Master of Arts in Intercultural and International Communications program. Angela Dawn Anderson. Nadine Sarah Biggs. Feng Yu Kai. Shirui Cao. Kindi Siobhan Carter. Megan Laura Connor. Manyun Hui. Samantha Marie Oliveira Estoista. Jennifer Louise Fitzgerald. Mavis Guo. Mohammed Noor Hassan, the Asper Foundation Communications Award. David Irwin Fraser Henderson, Public Ethnography Research Funding. Yuna Zhao, SSHRC, Canada Graduate Scholarship, Masters, and Founders Award. Mengyan Li. Mengan Liu. Donna Marie McGrath. Emily Elizabeth Payton. Elizabeth Joy Roden. Shirk Canada Graduate Scholarship Masters. Kang Liang Song. Thank you. Wan Yun Tsai. Lou Diane Villahermosa. Villahermosa. Thank you. Jingpei Wang. Meng Wang. Thank you. Chuan Wu. Pei Yao Zhi. Li Dan Zhang. Rantong Zhao. Zhihan Zhou. I am honored today to present to you graduates from our Master of Arts in Professional Communications program. Hillary Don Anaka. Angela Margaret Bond Schmidt. Bobby Joe Bradley. Deanna Marie Cameron Dubuc. Robert Brock Campbell. Tanya Patricia Croft. David Carl Devey. Kimberly Loreen Dewar, the Michael Real Award. Karen Lee Elgersma. Public Ethnography Research Funding. Melissa May Fryer, the Deanna Beeson Memorial Award. Melissa Helen Fudge. Kimberly Gail Gandier. Lisa Philipzik Gerlach. Sophia Maya Gray. Patrick William Casey Higgins, Founders Award. Angela Victoria Hudgens. Jamie Patricia Irving. Anar Jamal. Amy Joan Nezevich. James Christopher McIntosh, Chancellor's Award. Sage Patricia McIntosh. Rachel Patricia Molnar. Rory Owen O'Neill. Nicholas James Pasquale. Dorothy Patricia Roberts. Nadine Lindsay Robinson. Justin Ashley Runk. Alida Maria Temkin Weber. Ray Carolyn Ligason. Erica Elizabeth Timmerman. Chandra Holly Tremblay. Lindsay Margaret Van Geen. Rana Manette Van Tool, Shirk Canada Graduate Scholarship Masters. Kate Wise, the Royal Roads University Entrance Award, Public Ethnography Research Funding, and the Lorna Malcolmson Memorial Award. Shane Nelson August Weston. I am honored to present to you today graduates from our Bachelor of Arts in Professional Communications program. Casey Lynn Bashand. Madeline Jane Berlin. Founders Award, President's Scholar Award. Zhaoying Chen. Madeline Marie Dahl. Sheila Ann D'Angelo. Samantha Jean Daniels. Shay Gabrielle Davio. Lucas James Edward Damaral. Brianne Janelle Bellinger. Stella Antonia Fernandez Garcia, Founders Award. Jennifer Robin Gardner. Abdulaziz Abdullah Gaylan. Avneet Kaur Gill. Morgan Brianne Hansen. Amanda Lynn Hemingway, Chancellor's Award and President's Scholar Award. Marlene Rachel Iapolucci, the Royal Roads University Entrance Award. Kirsten Louise James, President Scholar Award. Olivia Elspeth Johnson. Lauren Dawn Kelly. Audrey Kirsten Kiss. Tamara Kukovic. Jason Jonathan Langley. Zachary Taylor Lastwika. Chelsea Amaris Lee. King Lee Yu. Kayla Marie Macklin. Martin Joseph Massel. Alexis Marie McDonald. Daniel Raymond McNeil, Cassandra and Carla Sims Award, President's Scholar Award. Natasha Helen Miller, President's Scholar Award. Christopher Lindsay Moore. Catherine Elizabeth Moore. Connor Reed Morrell. Kelly Roxanne Oldenburg. Dennis Frederick Oliphant, President's Scholar Award. Ugbad Omar. Yeah. Chloe Madison Resch. Jacqueline Nicole Ricks. Raquel Emily Rudenberg. Sushita Singh. David Michael Sloan. Brianna Marie Smith, President's Scholar Award. Sierra Rain St. John. Margaret Allison Stevens. Mohan William Stewart. Danielle Kathleen Sweeting. Manpreet Tandy. Abigail Abror Toledo Yama. Megan Jennifer Dawn Trudeau. Alex Ray Tubi. Daniela Vespa. Lynn Elizabeth West. Emily Ann Westcott. Allison Ann Weatherset. Lucas Deke Wilson, President Scholar Award. Pamela Shirley Hogan. Thank you and congratulations.
listen, that's what it's all about. It's about celebration. It's about the grins that you see sitting at the end of the of the stage, and people being excited about their success, and having family and friends join in as part of that celebration. So congratulations to the graduates. You deserve the applause that you got. You know, it's not over. I hope that you realize that, as the motto says, to live your learning, to continue to learn. It's about the opportunity to participate and to begin a longer-term relationship with the university and with using your knowledge. Dr. Turpel-Lafond suggested, you know, that there's some challenges and things that you need to take a stand about and be principled in terms of what you make, what you do, and what you choose to set your cause for, and be prepared to push boundaries and make a difference. The connections that you've made here on campus with fellow students and faculty should not be lost at graduation. They should continue. Use that relationships to build your future. You know, these are challenging times, and so what we need to think about is what's happened that allows us, in terms of our background and experience in education, to do something about it, to demonstrate to others, as well as ourselves, the value of what you learned and where you learned it. What will you do differently, personally, and as a leader, an agent of change? We hope you make a difference in your community. We hope to make a difference in yourselves. We would ask you to use reason, to be critical, to think and challenge ideas and conventions to make the world a better place. And need I remind you, after last week, remember to vote. You know, your vote may make a difference, and it lacks credibility if you critique the outcome of an election but haven't bothered to participate. So use your knowledge well. We challenge you to use that knowledge, make a difference in society. Use the knowledge and skills you have acquired as you assume your roles in life. Remember that Royal Roads is proud of your accomplishments and is here for you as you need to continue your education. And I was suggesting some of we have a doctoral program or master's programs that are pretty spectacular when you're ready. And when you pay off the first degrees. And anyway, can I get the graduates to rise, please? I'm going to ask family, friends, faculty, and staff of the university to join me in applauding each of you on the completion of your programs. I'm sure there's some people here who didn't ever think you would make it. Maybe some of those are standing, but you have, and you did it. And while you're standing, I invite the graduates, to applaud the family, friends, and faculty and staff who helped you along your way. Thank you very much. Congratulations, and you can be seated.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain at your seats until the academic platform party has exited the theater. Thank you very much.